Welcome to another wonderful session of the Microsoft Business Applications Summit. My name is Lauren Faber, and I am on the Power BI Customer Advisory Team, and I'm super excited about having PCL with us here today. And from PCL, we have Nathan and Danny here to talk with us. And before we get into more of your challenge and your solution, could you tell us a little bit more about what we'll be talking about today, your roles at PCL, and what PCL is all about?
For sure. Thanks for having us, Lauren. Today we'll be sharing how PCL is using Azure and Power BI to solve some of the challenges that have plagued the construction industry for decades.
Here's an overview of what we're going to cover today. So we'll introduce ourselves, like Lauren said, and our company. And we want to share with you some of what we face in the construction industry. We'll also dive into one of the solutions we've built on Azure and Power BI and demonstrate how it improves the productivity of our field staff. And finally, we'll share a bit about our own experience from our journey to Power BI adoption and the lessons that we've learned along the way.
But first, to start, a little bit about ourselves. I'm Danny Brunch, and I'm an Artificial Intelligence and Analytics Specialist at PCL. My role involves data engineering, delivering analytics on that data, and enriching said analytics with machine learning. Along with that, I design and develop applications that implement machine learning and AI in practical ways to enrich our business, whether that's creating net new applications to allow us to get data we need to use ML or enriching existing applications with these powerful technologies.
And I'm Nathan Wong. I'm a BI and analytics developer at PCL. And my role revolves around the development and maintenance of IT-managed BI applications, along with providing support and guidance for our community of about 400 self-service BI users.
By now, if you haven't guessed from the pictures, PCL is a construction company. We operate mainly in three main sectors of buildings, heavy industrial, and civil infrastructure. With an annual construction volume of $8 billion, at any given time, we have more than 700 projects on the go. PCL is also made up of more than 4,000 full-time hourly staff and over 10,000 hourly tradespeople. We found that by equipping our workforce with tools that help them to be more productive and efficient, we can improve PCL's bottom line.
Perfect. Thank you so much for that introduction. So let's dive into a bit about the challenge that PCL was facing when it comes to business intelligence and data.
Yeah, for sure. Before getting into the technical challenges, I'll talk a little bit about the challenges that the construction industry faces as a whole. According to many analysts, the construction industry is lagging when it is compared to other sectors. The chart that you see here from McKinsey actually ranks construction just above farming. Productivity in construction has flatlined. Rework comprises 7 to 11% of the total construction cost. Sometimes large projects can take 20% longer to finish than scheduled and can be up to over 80% over budget. Construction ranks as one of the least digitized sectors.
So at PCL, we're tackling these problems head on, and we believe that, like in many other industries, technology can be a transformative factor. One way PCL is doing this is with IoT sensors and the data visualization capabilities of Power BI. These IoT sensors give us real-time information of what is happening on our job sites. Rather than spending time manually taking temperature readings on job sites, workers can be allocated to higher value activities. We can ensure that the quality of our finished construction by monitoring and controlling environmental factors. We can also mitigate risks from unforeseen events like floods or inclement weather through early warning systems. This brings a new level of insight to our job sites, creating a more efficient, productive, and safe environment for our business.
And that brings us to our BI and data challenge. IoT sensors generate lots of information, and construction sites are large. It's not unusual to have hundreds of sensors on a single job. Our challenge was to be able to process large amounts of IoT data, deliver it to our field workers in a way that they could easily understand and consume. And additionally, with all of this information being collected, we had a great opportunity for machine learning and predictive analytics.
So what was the solution that you did end up coming up with?
So to allow us to deliver analytics on the large amounts of data generated by these IoT sensors, we developed a data pipeline pictured on this slide, utilizing resources from Azure Technologies. This solution is scalable as we expand this product beyond our own business to a SaaS solution with millions of readings generated per day. So to start off, the JobSite Insights application itself, you see on the far left there, uses Azure Data Lake as a cold store for all our sensor data. This is currently written into the data lake in large batches every 15 minutes. This data store is immutable and stores all of our raw sensor data. It's backed up and always available in case anything goes wrong down the pipeline or we need to make any changes. Support for streaming in real time is also available as our platform moves to provide real-time analytics. The data pipeline then starts off with an Azure Data Factory to pick up the new or changed data and make it available in Power BI. A Data Factory tumbling window pipeline is triggered, processing the new or updated data from the data lake. This pipeline runs an Azure Databricks notebook running on the job cluster that will extract the data from the data lake, transform and enrich it before finally loading it into Synapse Analytics. The Databricks notebook extracts raw data, consolidates it, transforms it into our analytics schema, and enriches it further with further lookup data. The process also batches up the data sent to Azure Anomaly Detection for analysis. This data is then also added to the dataset in order to show any readings that may indicate issues to our analytics users.
The data is finally loaded into Synapse Analytics to feed our Power BI dashboards and reports. With Power BI, we have one main certified dataset that is pulling from Synapse Analytics. This dataset uses incremental refresh, and we only look to refresh the last day's worth of data in order to keep our refreshes as fast as possible while keeping the data in memory in Power BI. The certified dataset also allows our clients and employees to create their own reports and dashboards where needed without assistance from our analytics team. This allows our many diverse project teams to be able to adapt quickly the base level of analytics to their own needs and the needs of their clients.
So I believe you've prepared a demo for us, and I'm really excited about you showcasing that. Would you be able to show us that now?
Of course. I'll bring it up on the screen here. So I'll be going through both the JSI application itself that provides us the real-time views into the sensor data and any alarms or alerts. After that, I'll go over the JSI analytics piece, which highlights the historical data and analytics available within the system. So starting off here with the JSI application itself, this application displays real-time data and alerts to our users in order to actively monitor their job sites, environments, and act on any issues that may be occurring. The JSI portal shows job sites or projects and their design drawings or layouts with the sensors, their GPS locations, and latest sensor readings displayed on top. Users can navigate across various districts, job sites, and floors or areas to view the latest sensor readings available. Teams can be configured to give access to other employees and set up alerts or alarms. Alerts and alarms are set on sensors or groups of sensors. Thresholds are set to get alerts if sensors' readings go out of these bounds. These alarms will send alerts to the employees through various email methods, such as text messages or email.
The great thing about IoT is that there's a sensor for everything. JobSite Insights supports many different types of sensors, typical run-of-the-mill sensors like temperature, humidity, and air pressure, to more construction-focused sensors like concrete strength and maturity, as well as pipeline pressure and valve states. The first benefit of having all these IoT sensors is that no more manual readings need to be taken anymore. Before, job sites that needed to ensure their environments were controlled had an employee go from area to area, physically taking measurements. The second and more important benefit, though, is that it gives us greater control over the quality of our final construction product.
So here you can see one of our demo job sites with a few simple sensor types. Employees can open the application to see the current environment of the job site from anywhere and determine if they need to physically go to locations if anything seems off. On this application, any sensors that have active alarms will show up in red. Alerts will have also been sent to the employees directly so they can act as soon as the alarm is triggered. A good example of this is on job sites where millwork is being performed. This work must be done and kept in a controlled environment to ensure temperature and humidity are within design thresholds. If these values do fall out of range, employees can act quickly, preventing damage and additional costs to our company.
A common problem when working on towers in the winter are pipes freezing and bursting, which can cause water damage to units below the burst pipe. Employees now can be alerted to the problem and address it quickly, or they can take preventative measures like closing a window or adding heaters to the rooms. This simple act can prevent large amounts of rework and additional costs to the project. Since job sites are constantly changing, sometimes it's not feasible to plan for every possible risk. During construction, it's easy for water to find its way into areas it's not supposed to go. And that could be due to heavy rains or melting snow. And rather than installing and then removing pumps over and over again in areas that need water protection as the construction progresses, we can use flood sensors to save the project money by allowing them to only install temporary water mitigation systems as needed once they're notified of water in a particular area.
So all these alarms can be viewed and tracked in the JSI application itself. Alarms will show up in red, as you can see here with this one demo device, and users can deal with them in real life. And then once they're done, they can go back to the application and clear these alarms to ensure that we know that the issue has been dealt with and nothing is outstanding. And we're not going to have any further problems there. If the device goes out of bounds again, we'll get another alarm and we can make sure that further plans can be implemented to make sure that nothing's going to go wrong on our job sites. So now you're getting a quick view into the JSI application itself, and I'll switch over to JSI analytics, and we can have a look at the historical data JSI and its sensors have generated. So the Power BI dashboard offers a view into aggregated summaries of the data, along with detailed data down to each individual sensor reading. The main dashboard you can see now shows the available sensor types. Users can set the time span of the data they would like to see, as well as selecting different job sites that they want to view on this first page. Further slicers are available on an options tab to filter specific areas or devices if needed.
Each detailed page provides an in-depth view into a particular sensor type. On this particular temperature page, there's a gauge that shows the range of values that has been experienced by the sensors, along with whether any of those values have fallen out of the thresholds that have been set. This page allows project teams to quickly review and identify any problems. The line graph displays trends which quickly highlight any anomalies that may have occurred. And teams actually use this dashboard extensively to ensure environmental conditions are met and sensitive areas are monitored. On a construction site, like I said before, where things are constantly changing, having this information readily available to teams allows them to respond quickly and make informed decisions.
One of the ways Job Site Insights has directly improved productivity is being able to monitor concrete strength and maturity once it has been poured. If teams know exactly when the concrete has cured and is ready to be built on, construction on that can start early. This saves days off the schedule, reduces equipment and labor costs, and ultimately makes the projects more profitable. Another way Job Site Insights has proved its value is when we need to provide proof that the construction environment conformed to specifications. If millwork is cracked and the clients are claiming that environmental conditions are the cause of the problem, we have all the historical data necessary to show that we did, in fact, maintain a proper environment. Warranty work and claims can end up costing a lot of money after a project finishes, and JSI analytics can minimize these costs. There are many other use cases for JSI analytics and JSI itself as the system continues to expand. I hope that this gives you a quick look at how we can use Azure and Power BI to help our business.
That demo was seriously so awesome. Thank you guys so much for sharing that. Hearing you talk earlier about how the construction business is on the lower end when it comes to digitization, it is pretty obvious that PCL does not fit into that category. I know that with any kind of solution that you're finding or challenge that you go through, there's a ton of lessons learned. Would you be able to share some of those lessons with us?
For sure. So one of the big things is when we first started out, Power BI was using direct query to connect to Synapse Analytics, but the queries took a long time to return and we ran into issues with report performance. On top of that, it was a fairly costly resource, so to get the performance to the level we want would be costly. To battle this, we first changed the way we were modeling our data to make it much more efficient. And also we pivoted to using an incremental refresh, which gave us the performance we needed, along with the time to update our data model. Along with that, an incremental refresh also allowed us to use a much lower cost resource as the performance to the database or Synapse Analytics was much less than was before with direct query. We also heavily use custom visuals available in the marketplace, and that has really helped us visualize our data concisely, telling the story that our users need to make important decisions quickly. We also found that having the knowledge to develop custom visuals yourself can also be very important. Custom visuals are great, but often they're missing one or two key features that would really help you present your data in the best way possible. One other thing we experimented with on the direct query side of things was using aggregation tables to speed up performance of large queries on large sets of data. Having these built-in tables in memory for dashboard KPIs can prevent the long load times that frustrate users. Finally, having a defined DevOps process can help ensure that changes to dashboards can be properly vetted before releases. Making sure that data is presented properly is of utmost importance before releasing to users and rely on the accuracy of data.
We tried to make use of bookmarks in order to provide our users with a really intuitive experience. We wanted our reports to feel like an app as the users navigate through it. We're also really careful about the number of visuals that we included on a page, as we found that sometimes having too many would actually bog down the performance of our reports.
You've created such an impressive solution. What are some of the things that you're doing to make sure that people adopt it?
So at PCL, we have a blended model of BI delivery where we balance IT-managed BI while ensuring our 400-plus self-service BI creators have the tools they need to succeed. One of the key strategies is simply being to listen to our users. When they see their data visualized in Power BI, they're the ones who come up with new ideas of using their data. New features or ideas that have a widespread impact are then prioritized. Additionally, we make up every effort to ensure existing report functionality is easy to use and flexible to handle most users' questions. If users need something more, they can easily access data via Power BI datasets and data flows to build their own custom reports. And on top of that, to make things even easier, we have a repository of report templates they can start from.
And aside from the great guided learning that's already provided by Power BI, we've actually created some customized training for the different construction job roles in our company. This allows our first-time users to quickly see the potential value and application Power BI can bring to their role. We also use Yammer extensively to host a Power BI community of practice at PCL. The goal of it is to promote sharing and solutions to common problems. One benefit that we've actually noticed is that as our community becomes more experienced, the support load that we on the IT side see is lessened as people are getting help from their local peer experts. This quote from our CIO summarizes our presentation and really captures the motivation behind everything that we've covered today. We have a significant opportunity to change the face of construction through the use of digital technology. And as you can see, our investments in Azure and Power BI are really what is enabling us to deliver solutions to our workforce that can revolutionize the way that they work.
Perfect. I want to say thank you so much, Danny and Nathan, for your presentation today and being able to share your solution.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you very much.